Welcome to the party, Commander. Not much of one today, since everyone is busy rushing around.
We're receiving countless requests from across the galaxy, most are handled simply enough.
Yeah, but some of those asks are draining our supplies as fast as we get them. Hypermatter, people, ammo, even food. It's getting hard to keep up.
Is there anything we can do about it?
Get more of, well, everything. People, ships, fuel, time. You know, the easy stuff.
We simply have to do more with less. We have some proposed solutions, but there are recent developments that we should discuss first. Sana Ray and I, along with the members of our Force Enclave here on Odessen, have kept a watchful eye for any further signs of Valkorion's influence.
I really miss the days when dead people stayed dead.
We are hopeful. The Force feels different, lighter, somehow, as if Valkorion's very existence was a weight that none of us recognized. Our enclave, the Voss, I'm told that even Satil's students have felt the change. It seems our ancient enemy is well and truly gone. I'm sure you felt it too, knowing your own strength in the Force. The question now is, how do we proceed?
We need to be sure he's actually gone, and it's not just another trick.
A prudent decision. I will instruct the enclave to continue searching for any signs of him.
So, on to the Mandalorians. It's a pretty crazy time for them. Shay Vizsla's taken down half the Darmanda on Mexha, but hasn't gotten any closer to this Field Marshal Cole. Indigo never was a hands-on manager. Probably didn't even know his people were involved.
As promised, Jakiya Ordo has been aiding our operations in Shay's place. Despite the turmoil in the clans, he's helped us secure escorts for our cargo shipments.
If the Mandalorians can't be counted on, find me someone who can.
I know some Machani mercs who jump at the chance. I'll put out feelers.
Going back to the numerous requests we've received for assistance from our allies across the galaxy, we have a potential solution. We already employ a number of incredibly skilled and resourceful individuals who could likely handle these requests, alone or in small teams. Additionally, between my contacts and Theron's, there are a number of outside assets we could recruit to fulfill our allies' needs. As we've done before, if those assets prove useful, we can bring them into the fold officially. A sort of field test, if you will.
I get the feeling you already have one of these tests in mind.
Naturally.
Our first situation is on Balmora. They're prepping a big shipment of turbo lasers for a Republic base on Corellia. Obviously, our friends in the Empire would prefer that those cannons never get to their destination.
Commodore Pardax knows of an external asset that has plagued the Balmoran governor for years. The asset is a Twi'lek using the codename Zenith. He hates the Sith Empire intensely. But that hatred could be used to manipulate him. Pardax believes we can feed him false intelligence, convince him the turbo lasers are instead being sold to the Sith. Zenith does our work for us, and Pardax uses the opportunity to take him into custody. Rather elegant, I think.
Agreed. Make it happen.
As you wish. I will have Commodore Pardax proceed immediately. I believe that's it for today, Commander. I'll let everyone else know what was discussed. Thank you for your time.
Hey, Commander. Don't know if you were expecting him, but Darth Rivix is here.
Rivix? He's here now?
Here and dying to meet with you. Alone. He was very insistent about that part. I made him wait in the operations room, said you'd meet him when you had the chance, but he said it couldn't wait.
All right. I'll go there immediately.
Commander, it's a pleasure to see you again. I must say how thoroughly I enjoy my visits. Seeing operations run so smoothly under your capable leadership.
I don't have time to waste on empty pleasantries. If you have urgent business, then let's get on with it.
Then we shall jump right in. My sincerest apologies for the theatrics. I have news to share that could not wait for a formal invitation.
Of course I'm sure! I'd know that maniac anywhere! I could feel his presence before he even set foot on Dantooine. The longer you sit around, questioning what I saw, the more time he has to get away with whatever he's doing in those ruins.
Our intelligence officers have truly outdone themselves this time.
What was that?
A secret meeting with Jedi leadership, or what's left of them. This woman, Aran Lanier, claims she saw Darth Malgus enter the Jedi Enclave on Dantooine. He was missing for so long, but it seems our errant Dark Lord has finally decided to show his face. Our Empress is displeased.
What do you mean? Malgus isn't acting under Ascena's orders.
Whatever fool's errand Malgus is chasing on Dantooine, Empress Ascena certainly did not sanction it. And any attempt to recall Malgus has utterly failed. Given the circumstances, the Imperial Reclamation Service proposed sending an entire excavation unit to search the ruins and apprehend Malgus. But the Empress does not want Malgus's newfound freedom to become widespread knowledge. So, I suggested a more covert approach.
And you need me for this covert approach?
Precisely, my friend. A small task force, you, me, and a very powerful ally, would be more than capable of investigating what Malgus was up to in those Jedi ruins.
Are you going to tell me who this powerful ally is?
Even better, I'll show you. Darth Krovos, your timing is as impeccable as ever.
I apologize I couldn't be here sooner. Logistics is field-testing new Colto packs and wanted my approval before they begin. I trust you've been briefed on the situation. We should depart before our window of opportunity closes.
You're going to Dantooine with us?
I'm sure I don't need to explain how dire the consequences would be if Darth Malgus has somehow gone rogue again. The severity of this mission requires my direct involvement.
I can't stop you from coming along, but you do well to stay out of my way.
My only priority is finding Malgus. As long as our objectives align, there should be no issue. We've waited long enough. If we don't get to Dantooine quickly, we'll lose Malgus's trail. I'll meet you both at the shuttle.
Darth Krovos, isn't the Hand meant to be working outside the Dark Council's influence?
Krovos is not like the others on the Council. She is steadfast in her commitment to strengthening the Empire, not to mention her considerable combat skills. At any rate, we don't have the luxury of being choosy with our allies. Unless we seize this opportunity now, we undoubtedly risk Republic interference later. Our shuttle is waiting. After you. We're nearing our destination. A few more minutes, and we'll be planetside on Dantooine.
How are you planning to get us down without attracting the Republic's attention?
Ah, you must remember, Dantooine isn't exactly a bustling metropolis world. Their government lacks organization, and when it comes to officially sanctioned travel, let's just say it won't be difficult for a small shuttle like ours to sneak in unnoticed.
It is imperative that we do not draw attention to ourselves during this mission, Riddix. I hope you remember that.
Of course I do. We should have no trouble reaching the Enclave ruins. No trouble at all.
Weren't you saying something about no trouble?
Blast! Our window was small, but I was sure we would be the first to arrive.
It takes the Republic military ages to agree on anything, let alone act. I can't believe they've mobilized such a show of force so quickly.
Walking through the front door isn't going to be an option for us. Suggestions?
Well, since walking right past those Republic soldiers and possibly scaring off our quarry is clearly out of the question, might I suggest an alternate route? Years ago, many people here scavenged what they could from the Enclave ruins to make a living. Their leaders didn't exactly approve, so they built access tunnels in secret. We'll undoubtedly meet resistance from patrols, but if we find one, our chances of infiltrating the ruins would be much higher than a direct assault.
And hopefully, we'll retain at least some of this mission's secrecy.
What other choice do we have?
None, I'm afraid.
Then let's go, before the Republic sends more reinforcements. Other than Republic soldiers, what else might we face in the Enclave?
With any luck, not much. The Enclave was destroyed centuries ago, and I'd wager most everything inside has been picked clean by scavengers. We'll surely run into a stray creature here and there, but other than that, I can't imagine we'll meet much resistance. I'm more concerned about what we won't find. I do hope Malgus's trail hasn't run cold.
You know, for a Sith, you seem pretty knowledgeable about the history of a Republic world.
Is that really so strange? My job is to be well informed about any potential threats to the Empress. If Malgus had resurfaced on Nal Hutta, I assure you that I would be an expert on the intricacies of Hutt politics.
Rivix, are you admitting there's something you haven't mastered? I'm shocked. I believe that was all of them. Hopefully, they didn't get a chance to alert their friends.
And here is the scavenger's tunnel entrance. Just as I said.
Let's get inside then, before any reinforcements decide to investigate.
How in blazes did these creatures get here?
What was that thing? I've never seen anything like it.
A Grawl. They're not uncommon, but seeing one underground and at this size, it's completely out of the ordinary. Not to mention its little friends.
Oh, at last. At last! Someone has finally come to help me!
That's far enough. Don't come any closer.
No, please. I mean you no harm. Truly, I am a member of the Imperial Medical Corps designation TL-30.
What are you doing down here, droid?
Darth Malgus brought me here, ma'am.
Did you say Darth Malgus?
Yes, I did. I was tasked with tending to Lord Malgus after the Battle of the Meridian Complex. Though his wounds were severe, he escaped our medical facility. I was his hostage. But he could not have survived on his own. I kept him alive while he considered his next move. Then he brought me here.
Where is Malgus now?
I do not know, sir. I followed Lord Malgus deep into these tunnels, but we reached a crossroads, and he continued on from there. Alone. He did not return. I had no choice but to find my own way out of these tunnels, but that great beast attacked me. And you made short work of it. Please, help me escape this horrible place.
We are not taking her with us. She's barely functional. She'll slow us down.
No, I don't want to go with you. I want to get out of here. All I need is a quick repair. Just enough to get me moving again. With the tunnels clear, I can manage on my own.
I'll help you, but you must help me find Darth Malgus.
Oh, thank you. Of course, whatever you need, it is yours. Much better. Here, the data in my memory banks can show you where Darth Malgus went until he abandoned me. It will show you the path he took at the crossroads. I can give you a copy.
Krovos, Rivik, scout ahead. Make sure there's nothing waiting for us. I'll meet you two when I finish transferring the data.
Noted. Be quick.
I believe that's everything.
Good. Took long enough.
All finished then?
I have a record of Malgus's every move in this place. We just have to figure out where he went after he left the droid.
Excellent. A new piece of the puzzle.
I would be remiss if I did not ask, but what if Malgus is still here? What do you plan to do with him?
Malgus still has his uses. We'll bring him back to the Empire if we can.
I am heartened by how clearly you see the situation. Whatever Malgus is going through, I am sure it is only temporary. I know he still desires to serve the Empire. The strength and power he offers are mighty weapons. It would be foolish to throw them away over an error in judgment.
What would you do, Lord Rivix, were you in my place?
My duty is to support the Hand, which means supporting you. Whatever your opinion is, I defer to it.
Unsurprising. But we've idled long enough. Let's continue.
If Malgus still wants to serve the Empire, Krovos, why do you think he left after Corellia?
Even after we destroyed the Meridian Complex, our old enemies in the Republic continue to mount a substantial resistance. Fighting this war as we've always done will no longer work. Malgus understands this. I'm positive that he's searching for something that could revitalize our ways of combat. Whether or not our peers will approve of anything he finds, I cannot say.
I would sincerely reconsider working with whoever told you this place was empty, Rivix.
I'm a bit curious, Lord Krovos. If Malgus simply wants to bolster the Empire, what is he doing in these ruins?
I never claimed to know the details of his plans. I simply believe that what he's doing is in the best interest of the Empire. I fought next to Malgus in enough battles to trust my feelings on the matter.
Hold on, someone's here.
Stop right there! Don't take another step! You're outnumbered, and we know how to take down Sith. Put down your weapons and surrender, imps, unless you want to leave here in pieces.
This doesn't have to get bloody. Drop your weapons, let us pass, and forget you saw us.
This is the end of the line for you. We won't let any imps get in the way of our mission here. For the Republic!
Where do these tunnels lead? Tell us.
Minar, wait, I know you. Where's Captain Minar? Let me speak to him now.
He's here and alive. The same can't be said for the rest of these soldiers. Tell me what you're doing here and what you've learned. Or this man joins the others.
No! Master Nares! Don't tell them anything! Please!
I would never. I'm sorry, Captain.
How unfortunate for you.
He's useless. Get rid of him.
As you command.
Let's figure out our next move.
The droid said something about Malgus abandoning her at a crossroads.
Yes, she did. Can you check her recordings?
This is it. This is the place.
So we follow the same path as Malgus took in this recording.
What if Malgus knows he's being followed? What if he manipulated this recording?
A valid concern. But unfortunately, unless we want to return empty-handed, our only option is to follow where this recording leads.
Rivix is right. We've come this far.
Then we'll keep going. Just keep your guard up.
Look at this place.
What were the Jedi doing here?
Altering memories, wiping minds, and other unsavory force experiments.
Really? I didn't think the Jedi had it in them.
How do you know so much about Jedi history, Rivix?
I told you. I wouldn't be doing my duty if I did not keep myself apprised of these important details. Even if I hadn't done my research, this place has seen so much death and turmoil. Pain felt centuries ago still resonates here, echoing through the Force. I'm surprised you don't sense it as well. Don't you feel it, Lord Krovos?
Enough. We need to keep moving. This is the only way forward.
Whoever built this door clearly didn't want anyone snooping around in here.
But someone got in anyway. Recently, from the look of these lightsaber marks.
Then we should see what's inside. Turn around. Don't try to escape.
Or what? You'll kill me like you killed my friends?
I can feel the anger radiating from her. And look what she did to her own people. Well done, Master Jedi. Well done indeed.
How dare you? I didn't do this. I found them like this. I guess Darth Malgus couldn't show any mercy to the rest of my team. Just like you.
How do you know this was Malgus?
Don't play games with me. You're Imperials, you know this was Malgus. Tell me what he was doing here, and tell me where the relic is. I know he took it!
We don't know any more than you do, Jedi.
Don't! Don't try to manipulate me. You Sith constantly outdoing yourselves when it comes to deceit. I've seen so many dark things, and it still shocks me!
Wait, something is wrong. Ignore the Jedi's whimpering. We should leave now.
You're not going anywhere. A transparent ploy like that won't stop me. I've faced the worst the Empire has to offer, and I return to the light. Once you're out of the way, I'll track down Malgus myself.
Don't do something you'll regret. I'm giving you a chance to escape. Don't waste it.
I'll take my chances. This is it. After everything I've overcome.
There's something so satisfying about killing Jedi.
You're disgusting. Just get on with it.
Stop! Something is happening!
Of all the people I expected to follow me into these ruins, you, Lord Krovos, were not one of them.
What's happening? How are you doing this?
Everything you see is your own doing. The bonds we forged in battle bind us together. They allow you to see this echo of my presence. This place. All the violence and betrayal it has seen disturbs the Force. Movement through these ruins is imprinted, especially if it's born of pain and anger. Those with enough power can sense it. You may have deceived your two allies during this foolish expedition, but I know you have felt my presence all along. Don't deny it.
I wasn't going to. I want to bring you back to the Empire. You are a pillar of strength among the Sith, and we will need you to defeat the Republic once and for all.
Perhaps. But you should know, I have removed the final tool that bound me to the Empress's will. I have done what so many Sith pretend to do but never really achieve. I have broken my chains. I will never again have a master. I will never let another rule over me. I will never return to the Empire.
I don't think you have a choice. The entire galaxy will hunt you down. Take your chances with us.
Do you think it's a coincidence that both the Republic and the Empire sent agents to Dantooine? Think, Krovos. Use that strategic mind of yours. I knew none of you could resist running to the Alliance Commander for help. And I knew he could not resist coming after me, even if it meant walking right into my trap. It does not please me to see you suffer the same fate as these fools. If only you hadn't followed them here, you could have been a capable ally in what's to come. Krovos.
Krovos, what's happening?
Go, go! Malga set a trap!
What? How do you
go, both of you!
Yes, Empress. It seems our worst fears have come true. Forgive the dramatics.
There is no need to apologize. I understand full well the seriousness of what's happened.
Indeed, my lord. Regretfully, Darth Krovos has confirmed our suspicions. Malgus has successfully removed all of the mechanisms we used to ensure his compliance.
Most unfortunate. What are our next steps? Did you locate the tome he stole from the library on Ossus?
We haven't located it, my lord. And what's worse, it seems Malgus added another relic to his collection. If the containment case we found on Dantooine is any indication.
How could this have happened? I trust that you comprehend the difficulty of the path before you, Lord Rivix. I do hope you are up to the task.
I believe I am, Empress Asena. I shall update you again soon. For the Empire.
Rivix.
Oh, my apologies. The briefing doesn't start for a few more minutes. I thought...
Did you start without me? I heard you say something about Dantooine.
My sincerest apologies. But Empress Asena was growing rather impatient for an update.
What were you talking about? Something about a missing tome. This is the first I'm hearing of it.
Yes. When the Empire attacked the Jedi colony on Ossus, we compiled an extensive catalog of the books found in the ancient library. After the assault on the colony, when the dust had settled, we discovered that one of the tomes was missing.
If I'm expected to be part of the Hand, then I want respect from the other members. I don't want something this important kept from me ever again. Understand?
Yes. Completely. Going forward, I'll do my best to inform you of important information the second I know it. The stakes are too high now to justify keeping you in the dark.
What was this book he stole? And do you have any idea what he took from the Dantooine Enclave?
I don't know exactly what Malgus took from Ossus. There was so much chaos. And the library was already in such disarray when the Empire arrived. As for what was being kept down in the Enclave ruins, that is anyone's guess.
So, what's the Hand's next move?
I'll arrange for agents to identify the relics that Malgus chose to take. They are our only keys to unlocking his plans. I'll also recommend that Darth Krovos deploy soldiers to investigate any Sith and Jedi ruins that Malgus might potentially target.
I expect constant updates on each of these fronts.
And you will have them. We may have come away empty-handed this time, but you will be the first to know when I discover Malgus's next move, and the Hand of the Empire will be ready for him.